start by maybe correcting that we are not American. We are actually of Swedish origin. Very few companies coming from Sweden, and if you call them American, then I think they'll not be very happy. But I think this is a 10-year-old startup, you would say, which changed the, you know, the streaming industry completely and brought music from piracy to paid. Just about me personally, I'm glad to be here. Is anybody using Spotify here? Hey, great, thank you. If the rest of you, please use it and give us feedback. Thank you so much. So let me give you a bit of a background about myself. I've been in the space, I've been in international business. So the cross-border word that I picked up from the title here kind of relates to me because I started my journey in international business, entered into internet around 2000. First couple of years into B2B. I was working with Bazi and eBay, which was acquired by eBay for about 5.5 years. Worked with OLX, built OLX 9.5 years, and took over the Spotify journey last year. We just launched 4.5 months back, and I think thanks to some of you here, we've been facing a pretty interesting response from everybody across the country, and we are still working on developing it further. What I'll touch today is about, you know, two, three things. I think one is that what I've learned personally over this journey, what I see as an entrepreneur, as a professional also, on what's been happening across the last few years. Because I'll talk more about internet and e-commerce maybe. I think there are a lot of entrepreneurs who have talked about other stuff. So I've seen internet from the year 2000, 2003, to now, and I think at that time also we used to talk about how big India is, or in how big India could be. I think we haven't changed much. We still are talking about how big India is and how big India can be. The difference is that I think that all that hype which used to be there, maybe 10, 15 years back, is now a reality. So we're talking about 500 million internet users, which can go to about 700 to 800 million. Addressable markets anywhere from different businesses from 200 million to 400 million. It is a sizable audience. And I think no wonder not only startups coming locally from here, but companies all around the world who made fantastic businesses are all looking at India as one of the markets where they want to invest. So what I will talk about is maybe why India is, you know, why India is interesting for these global companies. How have the global investors looked at India, how they have invested and how they are investing today. And I can share with you a bit about Spotify on how we are kind of building India. And I think through that you can kind of take a lens of how a global company looks at India and builds the Indian market. So the first part is about how India is why India is generating so much of interest. So I touched base on the total addressable market. But I think the bigger thing is that we have a very evolved market base. I mean, there's about 100 million people in this country who are quite evolved. They've traveled around the world. They have kind of speak English. So I think the products that we use globally, they're so easily replicable in this market. I think that's the first fundamental thing which brought many of these internet companies in India. They didn't even have to change their product too much. The UI interface is still in English. And I think you look at the social networks, the search product, you know, so many of them. Not much alteration was done in the product to start off with, but as we moved on, they are actually moving to India 2. They are looking to, you know, go down India 3. They are looking to go down and make that changes to the product. The other piece about there is how these companies have actually looked at India from how the middle class is developing. So if you look at the GDP itself, GDP per capita. I think we are slated to be doubling this in the next 4 to 5 years. So that means more and more people can afford for experiences, for products, which they never used to be able to do earlier. I'll give you an example of two companies I worked earlier. At eBay, when I was there 10, 12 years back, eBay globally in US used to be a lot about products, people were collectibles and so on. In India, people were not collecting products. People didn't have owned enough products out there. In the last company also, I saw the ownership of goods in this country was not that high. So if you see this, as the income rises, people are able to afford more products. And I think at Spotify, we are seeing people also in the media entertainment industry, people are also able to afford experiences. How many of you watched the World Cup match, India semifinals? Yeah, so all of you. So how many Indians were sitting out there in the stadium? So many of them. You felt it was the match was happening in India. You know, so I think the number of Indians traveling abroad, people coming here, I think people are moving around the world. I think so many of these evolved users are sitting out there. They have money to spend on experiences, and that's where the global companies are getting interested in India. The startup ecosystem. So I think if you go back to maybe 10, 15 years back, there were a few founders who had built companies. A lot of them struggled actually to succeed because of the penetration of the internet overall. But over the last 7-10 years, I think we've seen IPOs come up. I think there are, couple of them spoke on this forum maybe yesterday or today. So there are so many role models who have built successful companies in the last 7-10 years who have shown that big companies can be built in this country. So that's, I think, is a big thing. I remember it's a very interesting case of Roger Bannister in 1950s or something. He broke the 4-minute mile. So nobody was able to break that. And he broke the 4-minute mile. And after that, in the same race, I think 5 people more, you know, who broke the same record. So same thing is happening. I think people, when you go back, nobody thought that you can build a billion-dollar unicorn in this country. So when few founders came in, and now you see many companies, many people have developed a belief that they also can do that. And that's what international companies are looking for. So when they are coming to India, they're looking for where to invest. They're looking at either coming organically or developing setting up their own setup here. I think Spotify has chosen that route. I'll talk to you a bit more about it. But there are many companies who are coming to India to look at, okay, where to invest. And I think the second, that's a big area where I think if you are an entrepreneurs here, you should look at developing companies where you should look at attract foreign investment. There could be an exit route to sell to these companies. There could be an exit route to build it through an IPO. That's a choice, you know, people can make. But I think the international companies are not only looking to build businesses, but they're looking to also invest in businesses. So if I look at the last 7, 8, 10 years, companies like Google, Facebook, I think they've all built their businesses here. Spotify has chosen the route to build the business here. But there are many businesses which are like, I mean, Walmart came in, they bought Flipkart actually. So there are many other such international companies will come in, they will not have the patience or the will to develop a business. So let me come to Spotify a bit and I'll come back to some of the other things. Why Spotify has chosen to build and I think what we are doing today. So we've been 4.5 months into the business. Before we came in, we actually did a lot of consumer research around what India is, how people are consuming music, because we are not a business which wanted to bring a same playbook that we use globally and just bring it and paste it here. I think we have seen in the past experiences that many of those situations failed for people. So if you think what works in America will work here, in some cases it will. It shows, you know, the search, the net, the Facebooks and, you know, the WhatsApp, everything, it is working here. But there's certain products which may or may not work. You may not need to tweak it to your local taste here. So at Spotify, what we did was we went about building a local insight team. Then we second piece is about how do you build a local team? How do you empower a local team? So if you look at many other companies, they feel that they come to India, we can bring expats from outside, you run our businesses. It works sometimes, but I think you need to have local talent. We didn't even have local talent in India. We built local talent in our global teams. So as I said, we're a Swedish company. So if you go to Sweden now, and I think you see how many people are working on the product, and some of them are working on the India product, you see some of them are Indians. In fact, a lot of them are Indians. So that, I think, is very critical to, as you look at the country and you develop a country, you need to make sure that you understand the country. The third reason you look at why you feel that you would want to go on your own is when you realize that there are many people having same product offerings, but if you look at the actual usage of the product, it is not as much. So one of the data points we found very interesting, and I quote it very often, is that on Spotify globally, we see usage of 30 minutes per month on the Spotify app globally. In India, we saw that most of the players who were there, the average was about 1 hour a month. So that, I think, gave us an opportunity that it means that we whoever is trying to build the business here, and they have great companies out there, but they've not yet cracked it. They've not been able to, you know, get that connection with the user to be able to convince them to come back and use the product and use it often. So that piece is something that we are working on, and I think luckily for us, Spotify actually invests a lot on personalization, recommendation. So what we are doing is we are focusing on, you know, focusing on those kind of things. The third area where we feel, I think, is about localization. Especially in a business like ours, I talked about global companies in India, they look at India from, you know, one lens sometimes. That may be wrong, because there are very nice articles, I encourage you to go and search for it, of how India is actually not one. India is about India One, which is about 100 million users who are quite evolved, speak English. There's India Two, and then there's India Three, which is the largest population, which I think maybe around 1 billion or so. So how do you build product for not only for the India One, for India Two, or for the India Three? Can you build your product which kind of goes and satisfies all the three audiences, or do you are able to only capture one or two? So some products, some companies are able to do one, some are able to go into all these products. At Spotify, we believe music is for everyone, so our intention is to start with the India One, India Two, but in the long run, we want to see that how we can actually make build a business which can go to the India Three. And I think that is one of the reasons we've chosen to come on our own. The other piece that I see the trends I see in from what we see from Spotify is that there are a lot of opportunities for Indian creators to come in. So if you look at number of songs that are globally available, there are about 50 million songs or 45 million songs globally available out there. But in India, there is about 1 million or 2 million songs approximately which Indian artists are there. There are not many artists in this country. As you start looking at the deeper into the music industry, you start realizing that it's all about Bollywood music, film music, and so on. So I think companies like us, or global companies, what they bring in a perspective on what's happening globally. And globally, I think there is film music is not big. It's the independent music which is big. So we hope that in India we'll see that trend, and hope Spotify is part of that trend in bringing more artists to the fore, more not only within India, but actually taking them outside India. We're also looking at something on the side of podcast. So podcast is an emerging field. Just the way you've seen OTT space open out with companies like Netflix and globally coming in here, we see the space of podcasts opening up in this space. So here you will see a lot of potential developments happening. You'll see companies, you'll see startups. At Spotify, we'll probably look at more deeper into this. Globally, we are looking into it a lot. And those are areas for potential growth out there. So broadly, I think that if I look at global companies coming in India, I think the investments are happening across sectors now. I can talk about the internet stage, but I think there are every sector you pick up, you will find. I think the one big trend that we are seeing around is also that people are not only getting into total addressable markets, but they're picking up very small niche markets. They are actually looking at sometimes only a couple of cities, because a city is equal to one country globally. So you can actually build products for one city, and if that does well, you can scale to the next city and so on. So you will see all that happening, and hopefully more models will emerge, and I think more people will come in, more companies will come in, and the whole ecosystem will get developed in a better way.